We have had numerous cases of emergencies that we had to send in a medevac to pick up people.
If there is a patient and the patient would need to see a doctor, it would be impossible because we are not able to have a doctor in our 56 sites.
There is no established public transport system.
It was a combination of cars and hours of boat rides through the mangroves and the roads, partially are very rough or not existing.
We will run about 4 days, 5 days to get there from Lethem to Master Canary.
Guyana has around 800,000 people. 95% live on the coast. 5% are all scattered in the hinterlands.
We would have a community health worker at these facilities. The scope of what they can do is quite limited. We decided that we can change that using technology.
Most of these villages, they don't have electricity. We connect these computers to a Starlink satellite, and we're using solar to generate electricity. We're training our community health workers to use the technology. If there's a need to do some diagnostic tests, it can be 400 miles, 500 miles away, but they're seeing what is happening in real time.
If it's something that can be handled locally, the doctor would advise the community health worker what to do.
Prior, we didn't have a clue in terms of the number of hypertension patients we have, the number of diabetic, and now these patients have been identified.
It has an amazing impact on prenatal care.
Without this system, a lot more people probably would have died.
A critical part is leadership, and it needs to come from the top, from Minister Frank Anthony and President Irfan.
We are trying to link your health facilities with the main facility in Linda and Georgetown.
The system really had a big impact. One man said to me, all I do, I walk to the health center here and I can talk to a specialized doctor at Georgetown.
It is the most extensive telemedicine network in the world.